Herpes is a sexually transmitted infection that we commonly see in the outpatient setting. The most important thing to recognize is that it is self-limited, but importantly, understanding the diagnosis and making sure that it's something that does not subsequently get transmitted to other partners is important. Typically, when we see patients who have herpes simplex virus infection, they have ulcerations of the genitals. It can be something that can be very uncomfortable and painful, but is treatable with antiviral medications. Chlamydia is an infection that we see often in patients who have absolutely no symptoms. It's more common in men to actually be symptomatic. So in a man with a chlamydia infection, they will often have a purulent penile discharge and potentially painful urine. Herpes simplex virus is not curable, although it is possible to control the symptoms with medication. And what I mean by that is prophylactic therapy. So patients who experience frequent outbreaks can often be treated with medications that help prevent them from having frequent outbreaks. Additionally, that same medication is the medication that can be used to prevent transmission to a patient who's never been exposed to the virus in the past. Herpes simplex virus does not affect your ability to conceive. It doesn't affect fertility. However, we do prevent outbreaks at the time of delivery, and the main reason for that is for transmission issues to the baby. So we do give medication during pregnancy. That helps to prevent the outbreaks that occur at the end of the pregnancy, because if a patient does have an active outbreak at the end of a pregnancy, then an abdominal delivery or cesarean section is indicated and preferable over a vaginal delivery to help reduce the risk of transmission to the baby. Herpes simplex virus is not something that's curable. It is something that continues to live in the nerve root of the infected skin area. However, we can prevent frequent outbreaks with medication, and that same medication can also be used to prevent transmission to a partner who's never been exposed to the virus. Herpes simplex virus is controlled in the body through the body's own immune system. So initially, when a patient is infected with herpes simplex virus, the symptoms can be very severe. And it's not uncommon that in the primary outbreak of herpes simplex virus, the symptomatology is such that a patient feels very ill. They can have flu-like symptoms, they can have swelling of their lymph nodes in the groin, all those symptoms tend to be self-limited and will resolve in 7 to 10 days even without treatment. But subsequent to that, patients can get episodes of recurrences that tend to be less severe. The reason why they're less severe is because the immune system has been exposed to the virus. The immune system develops antibodies that then control viral replication and can help prevent the severity of the outbreak and subsequent outbreaks. So even though the initial outbreak may be very severe, the subsequent outbreaks tend to be not as severe. Additionally, if a patient has that diagnosis and the symptoms are recognized early in the course of the outbreak, medication can be started immediately, which will help decrease the length and severity of the outbreak.